Hi, Hollywood Lifers. It's Bonnie, and I'm here today with Mr. Malcolm Taub, and he is a top celebrity lawyer specializing in matrimonial matters. And of course, he's here today because we're going to talk about Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes. They reached a settlement today in their divorce, and it dealt with both divorce issues and, of course, custody issues of Suri. And they made a very unusual statement. I'm just going to read a line in it. We want to keep matters affecting our family private and express our respect for each other's commitment to each of our respective beliefs and support each other's roles as parents. Now, what do you think happened here? They were negotiating all weekend. Why do you think that they mentioned each other's beliefs? And what do you think went on behind the scenes? What do you think they've agreed to?
Well, I think it's very clear that Scientology and Tom Cruise's belief in Scientology became an issue. And obviously the lawyers were smart enough to deal with that issue in terms of the settlement. So this is just a settlement or a statement that's crafted by lawyers to benefit both of the parties. And I assume that Tom insisted on it.
Now, do you think, based on the speed of the divorce settlement, because there's been a lot of publicity about Katie blindsiding Tom by filing first, and he didn't really say much. Do you think she got what she wanted, which was sole custody of Suri?
Well, I think she got a lot. I think she got, first of all, residency in New York, where she could stay here with her child, and she got sole custody. So I think this was a very, very positive settlement for her.
Mm-hmm. And why do you think that she was able to have such a positive outcome?
Well, I think she did strike when the iron was hot, and she had some very, very competent lawyers. I know them. They did a great job for their clients. They came in, they got jurisdiction, and they brought him into court immediately on an order to show cause. And I don't think that a celebrity like Tom Cruise wanted to show up at 80 Center Street before Judge Matthew Cooper in the bright light of the public. They did a super job for this woman.
Hollywood Life actually broke exclusively that Katie had filed something called an emergent application in which she would be able to compel Tom to come to court to talk about custody issues. And that was supposed to happen July 17th in front of this judge, Matthew Cooper. Is he tend to be sympathetic to women, to the wife in the case?
Well, Matthew Cooper is a no-nonsense, excellent judge who's seen everything, heard everything. I don't think he would be swayed by celebrity status. I think that he would pull no punches, and I think he would call them the way he saw them. And if I was Tom Cruise, I would think two or three times before I came into New York and appeared before that judge at that time.
And why is that? Why would you? Because he would have done a lot of questioning about Katie's concerns about Scientology, possibly?
But certainly, when you bring on an emergency motion, it means that there's something special going on. And that would require some scrutiny as to the parties and why individual temporary custody would be important. So I think there must have been some facts in there that might have made him feel somewhat uncomfortable.
Right, about Tom, making Tom uncomfortable about having to talk about these things in court.
That's correct.
So we have to say that Katie Holmes' strategy, at least the strategy was crafted by, and you told me that she had top attorneys. Now, what do you know about the attorneys that she had here?
Well, the Alan Moyevsky is one of the major matrimonial lawyers in the firm. It's Aronson Moyevsky, and their team is a very intellectual, very bright, very aggressive team. I've worked with them on a number of cases, and I respect them, and I think they did. The proof is in the pudding. They did a great job, and this case broke the land air speed record for settlement in a major matrimonial case. So that's what we have.
When you have a settlement like this, do you expect that they're going to have a good relationship, Tom and Katie, and the good relationship with the child? Does it help?
They're hopeful to have a good relationship, and we can only hope for the best.
Well, we hope for the best too, Hollywood Lifers, because we certainly want Suri to have both her mummy and her daddy and be able to see them both. So thank you very much for joining us, Malcolm. Bye, Hollywood Lifers.